my name is Pilar Ibáñez and I'm the author of the book In Rain Fire. We're going to use this program to give you some advice to have a happy life. Today we're going to talk about finance or abundance. So the first thing is that you ask yourself, what is abundance for you? Abundance, you can find it everywhere in our nature. Oxygen is abundant, grass is abundant, water is abundant. Why not money be the same way? The thing is that you have in your brain codified that money is limited, and there is the problem. If abundance is also energy and money is energy, if you have your energy up, you're going to be more abundant. It's also very important that you understand that our brain works like in a triangle. There are some values, there are some experiences that you have, and also some beliefs. Normally, our beliefs come from the values that we have and the experience that we had about money in this case. So if you want to change your beliefs, you have to change first the experience, taking in account those values that you have learned since you were a little children. It's very important also that you identify what are the beliefs that you have with money. If somebody like your parents tell you when you were a little kid that money doesn't grow on trees, that's something that is going to be codified in your brain, and that's why you have that belief. But maybe it's because you had that experience for something that you heard, like this case, your parents. Or maybe the experience is something that happened to you, so you need to change the experience to change the belief. Also, you need to take in account that our world functions in dualities. There is black and white, up and down, in and out. So everything that is going on inside is manifesting in the outside. That's why you have to first change your beliefs. Because normally the beliefs, when you believe on something like money, you have like a thought. And then this thought is going to give you an emotion about that thought. This emotion is going to manifest in an action, and also is going to manifest in the results. So if you want to change your results in money, the first thing is that you have to go back and think, what is my belief and what is the thought that I have of money, and change this. It's very important also that you understand some spiritual rules about abundance. The first rule that I'm going to teach you is that there is a rule called 5 minus 2 and 5 plus 2. When you want to commit something in your life that involves money, you have to use the rule 5 minus 2, that is 3. 5 minus 2 is 3. So you have to try to do things 3 times. If you have one goal that you want to commit, it's very important that you try to do it 3 times. If you do less than 3 times, maybe it's because you are not so committed to getting that goal done. And the other rule is 5 plus 2, that is 7. Try to do things and projects till 7 times. If you pass the 7th time, the world is telling you and the universe is telling you that is that way that you are used to doing things is not the proper way for you. So it's very important that you use this rule to achieve your projects. Also, you need to know that you have to be in an environment that is healthy for you. For example, there is another rule that is called the connection between energies. I explain myself. When you want to achieve one goal that involves money, it's very important that you identify what is the reason deeply in your heart why you want to achieve that. And if you want to achieve it and that's the reason that you have in your heart, you have to have a group of people that will help you to achieve that from the bottom of the heart. If you are with someone that is thinking about the money, but you are thinking about to achieve a goal that is very pure inside, it's going to manifest in energy, because one is thinking in a way of energy and the other one is going to be like taking your energy out of you. So it's very important that you have that in equilibrium. The energies are very important when you want to change your finance. Also, it's very important that you start to make a plan of how to improve your prosperity. By a plan, I mean, first you make a list of things that you have today and you want to keep. Second, you make a column of a list of the things that you want to achieve and how you are going to do it. And you're going to also make a list of the things that you have today and you don't want to keep. If you compare the list, you will find out that sometimes when you want to achieve something, you are doing another thing. So that thing that you are doing is not going to get you there. So make a list of the things that you want to achieve and how you are going to achieve them, and try to connect the action with the real goal. That this will help you to make a plan and to go in execution. This will be very important, but also it's very important in the world of prosperity and all the energy that you're going to have to achieve your goals and to be more prosperous, is that you are gratitude. Gratitude is something that is very important for being prosperous. Why? Because we need to be gratitude in this moment about our debts, because they are teaching us that we have to improve ourselves. Also, we need to be gratitude on the teamwork that we're going to have with the people that are helping us, with the relationships that we are going to have with some of them or with ourselves. Gratitude is the key ingredient to be more prosperous and abundant. I hope all these different laws of energy and this plan of prosperity will help you to improve your finance and be more abundant. If you want to have more information, you can follow us in our social media. And remember, everything starts when you ask. We will see each other in another program. Bye.